Father, I thank you this morning for your goodness and your mercy. You have allowed us to gather together in this place one more time for the expressed purpose of worship and word. We thank you, Father. We believe the worship that we render to you is acceptable. And now, Father, the word that we share with these your people, we ask that you would bless it and them. Use my mind, help my mind, use my mouth so that I would speak your truths that are contained in this word today. And for this, we give you all praise. In Jesus' name we pray. And the church said, amen. Amen. Praise God. I started on last week, Romans chapter 12. If you have your Bibles, go there, please. Romans chapter 12, verses 1, 2, and verse 3. The Apostle Paul is writing a letter in the book of Romans. It is a letter to the church, the body of Christ as a whole. And in the 12th chapter, he says, I beseech you therefore, brethren, starting at verse 1, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable or spiritual service. Verse 2, he says, and be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed. Be not conformed, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, by changing your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. And then in verse 3, he says, for I say, through the grace given unto me, to every man that is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think soberly, according as God has dealt to every man the measure of faith. This morning I want to continue teaching on how to develop faith. How to develop faith that will make and keep you whole. How to develop faith that will make and keep you whole. In the text, the Apostle Paul, of course, is speaking to the body of Christ. He is speaking to believers. He is not addressing the world. He is talking to us, those who have become a part of the family of Yahweh God, who is our Heavenly Father, by receiving Jesus, his unique Son, as Lord. John's Gospel, the 3rd chapter, verse 16, declares Jesus is the monogenēs weos, which simply means he is the only begotten or the unique Son of the Father God. He says in this 12th chapter, Paul, therefore, brethren, I beseech you. And I want us to focus in on Paul's statement concerning faith, because that's what we're talking about, how to develop faith that will make and keep you whole. In this 12th chapter, the 3rd verse, he says that God has dealt to every man. And when he uses the phrase every man, he's talking about every man that is a part of the body of Christ. He says he has dealt to every man the measure of faith. And this statement concerning faith, again, and I say this over and over again, is only referring to those who are a part of God's family, because in 2 Thessalonians chapter 3 and verse 2, The Apostle Paul clearly states, after requesting their prayers, that the word of the Lord may have free course and be glorified, and that they would be delivered from unreasonable and wicked men. And that ought to be all of our prayers, say amen, that we would be delivered. Jesus said, deliver us from evil, ought to be our prayer, amen. From wicked and unreasonable and wicked men, because he says, for not all men have faith. And so it is wrong to say that everybody has faith. That's not true. That's not what the Bible says. The measure of faith is one of the many gifts that God gives to each and every child of God the moment that they receive Jesus as Lord. Now pay attention, please, but in order for that measure, and please hear me when I say that measure of faith, which the Father God gives us to do the job it is meant to do, which is to make us and keep us whole in every area of life, it is designed, faith is designed to save us, to protect us, and you ought to be saying amen, to heal us. This is what God has given faith to us for, to save us, to protect us, to heal us, to deliver us, and to preserve us. I believe that covers all the bases. Say amen. To preserve us emotionally, physically, mentally, socially, and financially. And everybody ought to say amen. That measure of faith must be developed. Say amen. He gives to us that measure at the new birth. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17 says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. Say amen. Now, Ezekiel chapter 36, the prophet speaks prophetically, and it says that God will give us a new heart and a new spirit, that he will take away that heart of stone out of us and give us a heart of flesh, say amen, that we would walk in his ways. Now, this happens for us when we receive Jesus as Lord. God does an inside job for us. He takes that stony heart out and he gives us a heart of flesh that is pliable, that is bent towards God. Say amen. He does that for every believer and deposits in them, in us all, certain fruit. Say amen. Galatians chapter 5 and 22 talks about the fruit of your recreated spirit, and then he gives a long line. I know we don't teach on these things very often, and that is to the detriment of the body of Christ, because these are the things that God has deposited on the inside of us: love, faith, long-suffering, temperance, meekness. Come on, talk to me, somebody. All of these are fruit, say amen. And they are the fruit of your recreated human spirit when you get born again. But I gave the illustration on last week, and I say it again. Fruit, in order for it to be consumed and not make you sick, must be developed. Say amen. I talked about when I was a little boy, I was anxious and I would go to the apple tree and we'd get them green apples and we thought they were good. You know, we would just eat anything back then. But after we would consume them, later on we would have a stomach ache that was out of this world. Say amen. And so green apples are not for consumption. They have to be developed. And when it comes to faith and all the fruit of your recreated spirit, it all must be developed. Say amen. Well, I believe I'm saying something, and I hope you're hearing me. In Romans chapter 4 and verse 16, Paul states that we are to possess the faith of Abraham, who is the father faith-wise. We know God is our heavenly father, but he's using an analogy. He says, Abraham, faith-wise, is the father of us all. So the question is, what kind of faith did Abraham possess? And Paul goes on to say in verse 19 that he was not weak in faith, but was strong in faith. He contrasts weak faith against strong faith. And then it says that he gave glory to God and he was fully persuaded. Say amen. Strong faith is fully persuaded. I don't care what you got to say. I believe what God says. Say amen. And strong faith says, I don't care what it looked like because I'm not walking by sight. Hallelujah. I'm walking by faith. And I believe what God said, regardless of what it looked like. Say amen. That's strong faith. Strong faith in the face of disaster says, I still believe. I still declare what God said. He himself took my sickness and my infirmity. By his stripes, hallelujah, I am healed. I don't care what it looked like on the outside. Strong faith declares what God says and gives glory to God in spite of what it looks like. Say amen. That's called what? Strong faith. Everybody say strong faith. It is fully persuaded. Now, listen to me. I'm going to make this statement. I want you to grab on to it. Real faith, strong faith, is we think it to be true. Say amen. We think it to be true. Well, what do you mean, preacher? We think what God said concerning us to be true. Now, here's how it works. Before you see it, you got to believe it. God is an upside down God. Say amen. God says the way to high is low. Say amen. If you want to exalt yourself, you got to first humble yourself. And he who humbles himself will be. Talk to me. Exalted. And God says you got to believe it before you see it. The world says, show me. I say amen. And then I'll believe it. God says, believe me, and then I'll show you. God is an upside down. He's a backwards, or maybe we're backwards. Say amen. Maybe we are upside down. Let me correct that. Say amen. God is always right. Say amen. Well, we think God's word to be true, whether it looks like it, talk to me, or not. Say amen. You did wonderful job in praise and worship, son. Wonderful job because you trusted God. Amen. Not trusting in the arm of flesh, not trusting in the arm of man, but trusting in God the Holy Ghost, who will always meet our needs. Say amen. The Father God in his goodness has dealt to every man, every last one of us. Say me too. Say amen. Say me too. Say he dealt it to me. Say he's dealt it. Raise your hand. Say he dealt it to me. Yeah. The measure of faith. But it is up to you and I to develop it. I was talking to one of our good deacons, Deacon Marcus. Where is he at? Is he here today? Amen. He's sitting back at the door. Come here. Let me give you an illustration. Quickly. Come quickly. Amen. I was talking to him about the need to develop the spiritual forces that God puts on the inside of us. Boy. My wife said, you got too many points. You ain't going to be able to get through them all. And she's absolutely right because God always gets to talk. You know, when you put the sermon together, God gets to intervene. Say amen. And I was talking to Deacon Marcus, and I was talking about developing faith. And I said, it's like lifting weights. I said, now you can bench 400 pounds real easy. You can get on the bench and you can do that real easy. But for me, it will be an impossibility at this stage of my development. 400 pounds, no. I can row 400, but I can't lift 400. But at one time in his life, 400 was an impossibility for him. Now, why is he able to do it, but I'm not? And the simple reason is he worked out, he developed his muscles. Say amen. Now, there's the difference right there between those who possess the promises of God and those who don't. One group or one individual decides he's going to build his faith muscle. Show him that faith muscle, brother. Put it up there. Amen. That's the faith muscle. Amen. Amen. Thank you very much. And somebody else is just eating candy and popcorn and at night asking for ice cream. And the only muscle is that stomach muscle that we develop. Amen. In all seriousness, that's why some people don't make it and others do. That's why some people have and others don't. It's not that God doesn't want all of us to have, but having is up to you. Now, here's what God says. You got to develop your faith. Because it's not strong when he deposits it in you. It is infancy faith or infantile. It is baby faith. Say amen. Just like love and all the rest of the spiritual forces that he deposits on the inside of us. Love got to grow. Say amen. Love's got to be developed. Say amen. And the more you know him, the more you get to learn how to love him. And that love for God begins to spill over into the lives of the people that you deal with. Say amen. To the point where you fall in love with God so much that you can't hate nobody. Talk to me. Why? Because you understand they made in the image and likeness of God and that Jesus died on the cross for them also. Say amen. And that God has a heart for lost humanity. Say amen. And God loves the worst of sinners. Amen. While we were yet without strength, Christ died for us. He didn't wait till we got it right. Say amen. That's love. Say amen. Unspeakable and full of glory. Amen. That's love. Amen. Watch this. Before I share with you how to develop your faith, and that's what I'm going to be talking about over the next few weeks, I want to show you five. Everybody say five. I want to show you five people whom Jesus said. Now, listen to me. He is the Word of God made flesh. He is God incarnate. He cannot lie. Say amen. He is the second person of the Godhead walking on the earth doing what God sent him to do. He makes statements concerning everyday people. And he says in five, there are more instances, but I'm just going to give you five. Now, really, I could just give you three because the Bible says at the mouth of two or three witnesses, let every word be established. That is legal. Say amen. I want to give you five. And today I probably will only get to two, maybe one, maybe two. Probably one. Amen. Because I don't want to hold you. Amen. I want to share with you how Jesus said to them, your faith has made you whole. Now, listen to me. God's power, we know, is available. Say amen. The issue is not God's ability. Say amen. Say it's never God's ability. It's our ability to access. Everybody say access. And it is through faith we access. I talked about a few weeks ago, maybe a month ago, that it is through faith or grace that we access by faith. Our faith accesses the grace of God. Well, our faith also accesses the power of God, the anointing of God, which can change every situation in your life for the good. Say amen. Amen. Now listen to me carefully. I want to share with you five, today maybe one, where your faith, where he says, Jesus says, your faith has made you whole, which tells us if their faith made them whole, and the word whole is pregnant. It's the word sozo in the Greek. We know what that word means. And according to Romans chapter 2, verse 11, God does not have favorites. Say amen. If he did it for one, he'll do it for what? Everybody. Say amen. And so the power is available, but accessing the power is the issue. And the way we access the power of God is by what? Faith. Say amen. I said, say what? Amen. You know, I'm going to tell you something. I went to my father's house. This was a while ago. He had an electrical issue where only certain plugs were energized in his house. And I was talking to Dad. I said, Dad, what's... And so he had extension cords running all over the house. And I said, man, this is not safe. This is not safe. We got an access problem. I said, now, let's go to your fuse box. And I went downstairs in that downstairs where it's dark and cold and all that other stuff and frightening, amen. And I said, open up the fuse box. And I look into his fuse box, and there's cobwebs and all kind of stuff. And I'm like, Dad, the power is out there on the line. The line has been run to the house. The fuse box takes the power that is run into the house and it distributes it all through the house. If you are having a problem or an issue with some areas of your house not being able to have power, then the issue is the fuse box. Say amen. It's not the power on the line. The power on the line is there. It's good. It's available. Say amen. The power is the fuse box. But it was only allowing a limited amount of current to go through the lines. When your faith is not mature, it doesn't mean you don't have some faith, but it may not be enough. Somebody talk to me. For the thing that you are desiring to manifest in your life. I hope you understand what I'm saying. And so I said, call OG&E. Nebraska Electric. I said, call Nebraska Electric. And I said, let me talk to him. I talked to him. Thank God my sister had already signed him up for in case, you know, some electrical problems go wrong. So the good news is he got a brand new fuse box at no charge. Say amen. Now watch this. The moment they put that new fuse box in, power went everywhere, all over the house. Say amen. What I'm trying to get you to understand is if we will develop our faith, hallelujah, which is really faith is accessing God's ability. Are y'all following me? Every area, say every area, in your life will be made whole. Not just your physical body, but your financial livelihood, your mental state, your emotion, every area. Amen. God has a word that he wants you to consume. Say amen. That will make you whole. Everybody say amen. All right, so listen to me carefully. I'm going to share five different examples. The first is found in Luke's gospel, and I'm just going to deal with this one today. It is Luke's gospel, the seventh chapter. Please turn there with me. It is a harlot in need of mental and emotional wholeness. I wish we would preach these kind of messages more because it helps people understand and see themselves in the scripture. Not that I'm calling anybody a harlot, amen. Let me help you there. But I'm saying that many of us need what? Mental and emotional wholeness. Some people struggle mentally, say amen. And they need their mind to be straightened out. Amen. And thank God, God wants to give you mental wholeness. Say amen. Emotional wholeness. Some people are just an emotional wreck. They've been through the ringer in their situation, their life, and they are emotionally crippled. And yet here God is letting us know that emotional healing is available to each and every one of us. Say amen. And I thank God for that. I don't know if you've ever been to a place where your mind was messed up and your emotions were out of control, but here's the good news. God wants to save you from that and keep you whole. Say amen. Luke's gospel, the seventh chapter, starting at verse 36. Let me give this to you and then I'll be done. Jesus is invited for dinner to the house of Simon, a Pharisee. He accepts the invitation and he heads towards Simon's house. A harlot woman, the Bible calls her a sinner, hears that Jesus is at Simon's, the Pharisee's house. And so she goes and gets her alabaster jar of perfume that she had been saving. She enters the place where Jesus is reclining. They laid on stoops and they reclined and their feet were behind them. And it was kind of like an open portal area where there was a roof covering and yet the people could come in and go in that environment. And listen to this. She gets behind him at his feet and she begins to weep. Now, this is an emotionally broken woman. This is a woman who has mental and emotional scars. She's been through the ringer. As her tears fall on his feet, and this, please hear this, she would wipe them off his feet with the hair of her head. She's down on the floor. Jesus is reclining. His feet are behind him. She's there crying, weeping because of the brokenness in her life. And her tears begin to fall on Jesus' feet. And she takes her hair and begins to wipe the tears off of her feet. And then she begins to kiss his feet and put perfume on them. I don't care what you say. This woman was toe up from the flow up, because ain't nobody in their right mind gonna do something like that and expose themselves publicly to the ridicule that followed. Are y'all listening to me? This woman walks in there, gets behind Jesus, and begins to weep, tears falling on his feet, taking her hair and wiping his feet. And then that expensive cologne or perfume, wiping it, that ointment on his feet after she has kissed his feet. My God from Zion. Simon says to himself, and I'm sure not just Simon, but a whole lot of other folk, and some of us are thinking the same way right now. What in the world is going on? What's going on, man? What kind of Jesus is this? Well, he's the kind that can make you whole. Say amen. Simon says to himself, this man, watch this, if he were a true prophet, would have known who and what manner of woman this is that touches him, for she is a sinner. Here's what Simon says. I would never allow somebody like that, who's a sinner woman, a harlot, to even touch me. And here this Jesus is, supposed to be God's man, supposed to be a prophet, allowing this woman to kiss his feet. Watch this. Then Jesus, who never stops her, asked Simon a question about two people who could not pay a debt. He said, I got a question for you, Simon. Simon says, go ahead, Lord. Two men, both owed a creditor. One, $500,000. The other, $50. And he decided in his grace and mercy to forgive the debt of both men. And he asked the question to Simon, which one would be more thankful? Which one would, in expression of their gratitude, show love? And then Simon said, of course, the one who had the greatest debt would be more grateful and would show more appreciation. Then Jesus looked at this woman, and I hope we are seeing her in ourselves today, kneeling here. He said, look at her. When I entered your home, when I came in at your invitation, you didn't offer me water. You didn't offer me a cup of water. Watch this, to wash the dust from my feet. But she has washed them with her tears and wiped them with her hair. You didn't offer me nothing. You just said, come on in. Watch this. You didn't greet me with a kiss, which was the custom of the day, to greet everyone with a holy kiss. Watch this. But from the time I came in, she has not stopped kissing my feet. Watch this. You neglected the courtesy of olive oil to anoint my head, but she has anointed my feet with rare perfume. Then Jesus, God, rises up on the inside and says, I tell you, her sins. And then he says this, though they be many, thank God for Jesus, say amen. He said, though they be many, have been forgiven. So she has shown me much love. But a person who is forgiven little only shows little love. Talk to me, somebody. Here's what he says. He says, man, she's got a long list of transgressions against God and against man. But guess what? This act of faith on her part has moved me, talk to me somebody, to wipe her debt and to make it clean. Say amen. Listen to me. Here's what he says to the woman. Then he says, watch this, to the woman, your sins are forgiven. And then he uses this, he says this, your faith, say your faith. No, say my faith has saved you. And then he turns around and he tells this woman, he says, now go in peace because I've forgiven you the debt. Here's what he's trying to get us to understand. Faith in the right person can get the slate all the way clean. Say amen. And that right person is Jesus. Thank God for Jesus. And your faith in him. And listen to me. Some of us are struggling with our mental and emotional turmoil in our life, not understanding that there is what? Forgiveness. Say amen. For even that, say amen. Oh, thank God for Jesus. Listen to me. There is nothing you can do that is outside of God's ability to forgive. Say amen. All you got to do is bring it to him. Say amen. And she brought herself to him in faith, and Jesus turned around and says, your faith has made you whole. Now, this is what I want you to grab a hold of, and this is what I want you to always remember. This woman, who was in dire need of mental and emotional wholeness, Jesus says to her, your faith has saved you. And here's the point. If her faith gave her mental and emotional wholeness, your faith can give you the same if you would just develop it. And with that, say amen. Amen. Close your Bibles. Amen.